Accessing a private instance with the help of the Bastion service.
In this session, we will connect to this private virtual machine through a Bastion service that is also residing in a private subnet. Firstly, let's check the infrastructure. Under the networking, we will find the VCN and the three subnets that we saw in the picture. Under compute part, we will find the instance that resides in the private subnet. Now let's begin creating the Bastion. So under Identity and Security, we will find the Bastion service. Let's go with Create Bastion. We select a name. For this example, I'm going to use Bastion 1. We select the virtual cloud network. And we select the subnet, exactly the subnet that we have created for the Bastion. Now we whitelist the persons that we want to allow to access this service. So I'm going to select here, I'm going to put a random IP, which will be 9090. And I'm also using my IP address, but this one will be blurred. And we go with Create Bastion. For this Bastion to work, we need three prerequisites. The first one is to allow the instance to be accessible from the Bastion service. In order to do that, we access the instance and under Oracle Cloud Agent, we enable the Bastion service. The second prerequisite is to have a service gateway and enable that gateway in the route table. The third prerequisite is to allow the traffic to flow from the Bastion to the private subnet with an egress rule and to allow the private subnet to receive incoming connections from the Bastion on port 22. We go with Create Session and we select the type of session that we need. For this example, we're going to use the Managed SSH session and we select a name. I'm going to let it by default. The default username of the Linux machine that we have is OPC and we select the instance from the private subnet. The next step would be to select the encryption for the Bastion. So we're going to choose the SSH key, the Bastion 1, and we go with Create Session. Now, because the session is active, we will take the command from here and use it to connect. Now keep in mind that we have to replace the comments of the private keys with the actual private keys. So the first private key is the Bastion's one. So I'm gonna write here Bastion.key and the secondary one will be of the machine. So I'm gonna write VM.key. Now, as you can see, we are in the instance that resides in the private subnet.